Hey guys, Russ here with Blue Line Wood Flags. Today I am really excited because I get to show you my CNC machine and give you a tour of it. I've had it for approximately 6 months, so let's call it the 6 month review. Let me preface this video by saying that everything you're gonna see in here I purchased on my own, including the CNC and all the accessories. Nobody's paid me for anything, nobody's given me anything. Everything you see, I've bought on my own. I will provide a description and links to all this stuff in the video description. So if you're interested in sourcing any of the items, you'll know where to go, where I've gotten them. So without further ado, let's take a look at the machine. Axiom AR6. I chose the basic model, and the difference between the basic model and the pro model, I think they call it the pro model, if I can hold this camera still, is the basic model uses a router, where the pro model uses an actual water-cooled spindle. I chose the basic model because I didn't have a need for a production-grade unit that was going to be running basically 8 hours a day, 7 days a week. I do most of my stuff on the weekends when I'm not working my regular job, and I felt that a router would give me sufficient quality, and if it ever burned out after time, it's fairly inexpensive to replace at about $100-$150. I think the water-cooled options, or just the spindles alone, go for about $900. So if that ever burned out, that could potentially be an expensive issue. Let's see. So I guess starting from top to bottom, as you can tell, please don't mind the shop. It's kind of dirty. I did get the vacuum assembly. It attaches on the back of the machine right here. It bolts on. And basically your dust collection system hooks on here. I had to kind of modify it a little bit with some duct tape, which has worked really well with the plastic attachment that I've used. But basically this thing is, it's a beast. It was heavy putting it on. It's just solid steel. It goes up here so it stays out of the way of all your workpiece, and comes down your plastic flexible hose attaches to this, and it moves over the work surface, so it just basically stays out of the way of everything. And then it's got a brush dust shoe that attaches with rear earth magnets to keep it in place. So when you're going over and you're milling your work, this comes down on the work surface and all your sawdust is sucked up this tube. I would highly recommend this accessory. I like a clean workshop, and really honestly speaking, when I have this dust collection system going, it has cut down on a lot of the mess. I've run it without it, and it's just, if you know anything about CNCs, they throw sawdust everywhere. So let me just give you a quick glimpse of my dust collection system. It's homemade, it's nothing special. The hose goes over here to a dust deputy collector, which in turn goes into a rigid shop vac. And then I've got that tied into a remote controlled switch. So I usually carry this little remote controlled switch right here on my belt. So whenever I need dust collection turned on, I just simply press that green button and it starts the unit. This thing is a beast, like I say, and that's one of the reasons why I chose Axiom. I mean, if you look at the quality of the unit, you can tell by these heavy duty ball screws right here. Some of the lower grade machines and the entry level units use belts. I decided from the beginning that this was a personal decision of mine, that I just wanted to spend the money in the beginning and get something that I knew would last, and that was maybe a step up. Let's see, where can we go from here? The work surface, made out of 1-inch MDF, the spoil board. And if you're looking right here, I'll point it out to you. Right there. Yes, I did have a boo-boo, and this happened within the first month of me having this unit, and it about tore my heart out. I wasn't paying attention when I put the unit together. It arrives pretty much put together, but you have to attach a couple things, and one of the things that you have to attach is the Z-axis, the up and down motor that drives that Z-axis, and it's located behind this cover. And I must not have had that tight enough, and probably, like I say, about 3 weeks, a month into owning it, I was running a project and wasn't paying attention, and a V-bit that I was spinning had gone through my workpiece, and I noticed it because I smelled something in the air. It was a total rookie mistake, and I was like, uh-oh, something's burning, and I just happened to look over at the machine, and sure enough, my bit was grinding down in there. But it didn't go down to the aluminum bed, so I lucked out. So I just got a little ugly thing to remind me to pay attention all the time to what I'm doing and when I'm doing it. This whole unit weighs probably about 700-800 pounds, I want to say, with this base that I purchased with it. It is solid steel, and it is heavy. And just this top unit right here, just the unit, not the base or the tool cabinet below, took three of us, or actually four of us, to lift this thing up onto the base and get it bolted down. It was heavy. I put the base together by myself. That it was adventurous, but I was able to do it and get the toolbox situated on there. Let's see, still working up from the top. Well, let me turn this thing on for you. It's really simple. You just turn that unit on right there, and it goes through a power-up procedure on the handheld device, and it'll tell you by percentage wise. And then when it's ready, it'll say all access home. And you wanna do this every time you turn this machine on, is you wanna bring all the axes home. And you just simply do that by having it highlighted and hitting it okay. And the unit will go to the front left position. So, as you can tell, that work surface is lit up a little bit now. And that is because, along with the unit when I purchased it, I also purchased an accessory. It's this LED light strip, which I attached on here. And worth its weight in gold. I wear glasses, so sometimes things are hard for me to see. And this has really lit up the work pieces. And as you can tell, these wires, just if I can get it to focus, they go into this hole right here, and it was just a couple cable clamps that just tie into some existing hot leads. They give you the instructions and tell you how to do it. It was very, very simple. It was just a matter of taking off these screws on the outside and pulling this cover off and attaching it. But for the price, definitely worth it. The adhesive, somewhat questionable. I had to go buy some aftermarket 3M, I forgot what they call it, but it's like the really, really good quality double stick tape by 3M. And since I've used that double stick tape, I have not had a problem whatsoever with that light falling off. But the first time I put it on with the adhesive that it came with, must have been some cheap Chinese stuff or something, it fell off within like the first couple hours. But then again, I live in a warm climate, so that probably has a lot to do with it. But go with the good quality double stick tape. Just count on knowing that you're going to have to use that. So let's see, where can I go from here? Good quality aluminum bed gives you these T-slot tracks right here in various locations where you can run clamps down. As you can see, I've got a clamp right here. It just basically, you can position these clamps any way you want, hold your workpiece down. Definitely the way to go, in my opinion. And then if I have to go through a workpiece and cut something out, I would of course probably lay a sacrificial spoil board down on top of this, clamp it down, and then there's some various techniques that you can use to hold your workpiece to the sacrificial spoil board so you can make your through cut without damaging this top piece right here. Axiom recommends that when you get your CNC in place that you go ahead and Do a leveling cut on your spoil board. I did that. The unit comes with a spoil board cutting program built into it. You just gotta use a spoil board cutting bit, and it will take a couple thousandths off the top of this and basically level your surface once you get your machine leveled. And your machine's leveled with those leveling feet on the bottom. Control panel is relatively easy, or relatively simple, I should say. It's just got a power button, which is the green button, and an emergency stop. And this right here is for the pro models. Nothing. It's a blank on the basic models. And I think that just is for like the speed of the spindle and how fast it's turning. But it doesn't apply to this unit. And then the handheld Rich Auto device plugs in right there. And as you can see, that's the handheld device. That is primarily one of the reasons why I went with this model. Not only because it is so stout and can handle a lot, it's a commercial grade machine, but this thing right here allows you to do all your CAD CAM designing and specifying all your tool paths in the comfort of your office or home. You then load your project onto a thumb drive, and then let's see if I can get this open without, I'm holding the camera with one hand, so. But anyway, you can see right here on the top, it says USB, I think, yeah. This little thing pops open and you can plug your thumb drive in the top, and then you can run your project after you've copied it onto the thumb drive. In my opinion, worth its weight in gold. You don't have to have a laptop computer out in the shop. You can just plug in your project and just cut your tool paths as you need them. Later on, I'll make a video showing you the process of doing a simple project so you know how you go ahead and design it in the CAD-CAM software, how you load it onto the USB thumb drive, and how you go ahead and transfer that to the machine and cut the project. Let's see, what else do we have going on here? The only thing else I've done to it custom is put my little Punisher sticker on it, but that's me. Let's see, toolbox was an accessory. I chose to get it just because it was a neat place to house and protect the CPU down there. And it's also got some drawers for storage of accessories that I use constantly. So like in this first drawer, I keep my manuals in case I have to refer to them. It comes with a touch-off puck device to help you get your Z-axis. And then just some other things that I use quite a bit. This is my collet wrench, and also a tape measure. This is a metric and inch tape measure. I find myself using metrics quite a bit. Not saying that you will, but I do quite a bit just to get a different degree of accuracy sometimes, so that helps. I've got some different clamping options right here that fit into the T-track. If I need to use them, they're available. And then I get a lot of my bits and stuff from Tools Today. I'm not endorsing them, but that's who I use. Let's see, in my second drawer, this is my bit drawer. I've got all my bits kind of somewhat organized by what type they are. I've got my end mills over here. I've got my V bits over here. I've got some spoil board cutters over here, and I've got some specialty plastic cutting bits here, and some shank extensions or CNC extensions if I need them. Let's see what else. Oh yeah, I've got a, this you will need. It's a set of calipers right there. Everybody knows what calipers are. I think this costed me, I wanna say about 19, 20 bucks. And your CAD design software will sometimes ask you for the thickness of your stock. So be sure that you have an accurate measurement when you're putting your specs into the CAD program. Speaking of CAD programs, I use VCarve Pro by Vectric. Very intuitive, very easy to use. Little bit of a learning curve, but once you figure the ins and outs, it becomes relatively easy. And a shout out to Mark Lindsay. He helped me out quite a bit just viewing his videos alone. He takes Vectric very seriously, and he's a good teacher when it comes to teaching the processes that are used. Let's see what's in the next drawer. Oh, okay. So I've just got a little container of some T-Track accessories. And then this is all my collet. That's my collet care stuff. It's lubricants for the collets. And then I have some specialty collets that I purchased. They're by, let's see, Tink and Tinker, I think is the name. I can focus on that. There we go. Tink and Tinker Limited. Collets, tool holders, 3D carving tools, carbide micro tools, etc. They're out of Palmer Lake, Colorado. Definitely recommend them. What I do is, you can see like there's the collet holder right here. And then I've got some different size collets. I've got a quarter inch, a half inch, and then I've even got a 1/8 inch. By using these collets, you're getting more of a better hold. I'm not saying that the router collets don't do the job, because they certainly do, but I wanted to ensure that when I put a router bit and or a milling bit into the end of this router, and it's spinning at, you know, 23,000 RPMs, that it's held securely in there and it's not going to go anywhere. And my degree of accuracy is going to be greater than a stock collet. So yeah, you can see that this wrench right here is notched out, and that's made to go in there into the collet itself. Moving on along. Let's see, what else can we show you? Oh, the last, yeah, that was that drawer. Last drawer, what other accessories? Oh, that's just some of my original equipment. And then I've got the container that my router came with. I just keep it in there. So that is an overview of my CNC machine. Like I said, I chose it just because when this was in the market for a CNC, I wanted to buy something that I knew would last, that was maybe a little bit above an entry-level unit that could handle, a little bit more work that I wouldn't have to tinker with constantly. I wanted something that was ready to go, more or less out of the box. Like I said, I had to do very little assembly with this unit. Just attach that top stepper motor on and put the CNC onto the base, some minor assembly. But other than that, it was done. And it has proven to be worth its weight in gold. Not knocking any of the other manufacturers. I did consider some of the other ones in the beginning, in my very beginning research. I was looking at the Shapoko and the Inventables X-Carve, and they had some good reviews, but my mind changed just while I was looking at some durability issues and the capability of producing more work on a commercial grade basis. So anyhow, that's it. I hope you've enjoyed it. Like I said, Axiom has not paid me to do this video at all. I just believe in their product, and when I believe in a product, I promote it, and that's my opinion of it. So I hope this has been helpful to you. If you've enjoyed this video, please like it and consider subscribing to my channel. Thanks, guys.